Hey everybody, today I have something that is a complete game changer if you intend to use your EV as a backup power source for your home in the event of a power outage. So one of the big benefits of having an EV is some of the auto manufacturers actually allow you to use the battery pack that's in the car as a power source. A lot of times they market it towards like camping or powering equipment in the garage, but you can also use it to provide backup power for your house in the event of a power outage. Offhand, vehicles I know that have this feature are the E-GMP platform vehicles like the Kia EV6 that I have, the Hyundai Ioniq 5, the Genesis GV60. There's also the Ford F150 Lightning that has the capability to act as a generator as well. So the way it works, these vehicles actually have 120 volt outlets or adapters that basically give you a 120 volt outlet. And then you can run an extension cord or power an appliance directly by plugging it actually into the vehicle. So typically what I see people do is they'll run an extension cord from their car in the garage into the house, maybe plug in a power strip, plug in a couple of lamps, maybe a space heater, pull the refrigerator out, plug that in. And while that works, you are running wires throughout the house and it can be kind of a hassle. By far the best option, in my opinion, is the home transfer power kit from Nature's Generator. This allows you guys to power circuits directly from the car in your electrical panel. So all you'd have to do in the event of a power outage is go out there and flip it from grid power to car power and you'll be good to go. They have two kits available, which I'll provide links in the description for you guys, but one is the Elite kit that I got that allows you to power up to 6 circuits, and they also have a normal kit which allows you to power up to 4 circuits. It's a little bit less expensive, so depending on what your needs are, you can get the Elite or the normal kit, but either one will allow you to power your home in the event of a power outage very easily. I also partnered with them to be able to provide you guys a discount on the kits as well. They already provide free shipping in the United States, so I got them to give you guys 10% off if you use the discount code TECHJEFF, no spaces, TECHJEFF. So that will also help with some of the savings for you guys. Now I'm gonna be having my Elite kit installed later this week by an electrician. I'll be sure to snap some photos and do a video for you guys. That way you can see what the installation entails in case you wanna try installing it yourself. For now though, I'm gonna go ahead and open up the packaging and take everything out for you guys and give you a quick overview of what's included. So this is everything that's included in the Elite transfer kit. We have the main transfer switch here, which houses all of the switches and the breakers. We also have all the wiring coming from the transfer switch that go over to the breaker panel. They're all very clearly labeled. We also have the conduit that will house the wiring that allows it to be safely run from the transfer switch to the electrical panel. We have the hardware that's necessary for some of the installation, as well as the outlet itself that connects to the transfer switch that you will basically plug the vehicle into. We have a 10-foot extension cord here that allows it to be plugged into the vehicle. This is the Elite kit, which comes with a 30-amp extension cord. So you do have to get an adapter. I did get an adapter off Amazon. This is a TT30R. I got an adapter for less than 20 bucks and it looks really good. So this should work well. Even though it is 30 amps, one thing to keep in mind, I don't have to really worry about overloading the circuit because for my EV6 and for the EGMP cars, it maxes out at 1.9 kilowatts, which is basically 15 amps. So I don't have to worry about accidentally pulling more than it actually can handle because the car will just shut off at that point. And then we also have the instructions down here, which obviously outline how to install it and how to utilize the switch. So I've determined that I can power with my 6 circuits. I can power, honestly, the majority of my house in the event of a power outage. Now, when it comes to like cooking, my microwave uses around 1500 watts. So I can't cook and heat the house at the same time, but that's very easy for me to just make sure that I don't have my heat on whenever I try and use a microwave in the event of a power outage. But other than that, I have no worries about accidentally pulling too much power in the event of an outage. So overall, I'm really excited about this. I can't wait to get it installed. Last year, I live in Virginia. We lost power for 4 days. The house got down to in the 40s temperature wise, which was ridiculously cold. So I'm really excited to be able to utilize this to power my house, provide some heat. Now, I know some of you guys are probably wondering, can you really power a house with a car? Can it provide enough electricity to do that, enough current? And the shorter answer is you can power most things. I have solar panels, so I have consumption monitoring. I can see exactly how much power is being used. And my refrigerator uses around 200 watts. My furnace, since I have gas heat, uses around 500 watts. TVs use less than 100 watts. Lights, I have all LED lights. They use around 9 watts each. So I should be good to go. I can't wait to get everything installed and test everything out and show you guys how it all works. I'm really excited about the pricing too. So after my 10% discount code, the Elite kit is just over 300 bucks. And the standard kit is just over $200. And installation, if you don't do it yourself, you can expect to pay maybe $200 to an electrician to install it, which isn't bad at all. So you're talking $500 to $600, and you can have a very easy way to power your house in the event of a power outage that doesn't require running extension cords and moving a refrigerator and that type of thing. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section. Let me know if you have any questions about this at all. Make sure you guys use that discount code if you do go ahead and purchase. That way you can get that 10% off. And I will see you guys in the next video. And thank you for watching.